People come for me in the comments and say, oh my god, you're not supposed to do something because of money. You think I want to do anything? There are a lot of you who say that the reason why you cannot get into tech is because you don't have a laptop. That is not an excuse. Hi my loves, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Moyo and I'm currently teaching myself how to code. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys why I started learning how to code, the ups and downs I've faced so far, how I've solved those problems, and also if you are thinking of learning how to code, I'm going to be giving you some tips that will help you in your coding learning. Honestly, some of these things I wish I knew them before I started learning how to code. So if you're interested, make sure you watch this video till the end, and also please subscribe to my channel to get more updates on tech related and coding related things, because I'm going to be doing more of this kind of videos. So make sure you stay subscribed and turn on post notifications so that you get notified anytime I post. Without any further ado, let's get into the video. So the number one thing, the big question, is why did I start learning how to code? There are different reasons why I started learning how to code. The first one was because I wanted to make a switch from fashion to any other thing, and then I considered different, you know, career options. Do I wish I know what I know now? I wish I knew it then. But all the same, I found out about coding, and coding seemed very, very logical because the line of work I used to do is like hustle, bustle, you know, you go out, you source for fabrics and all of that. I didn't want to do any of that. I wanted like a job that can allow me to work from home, more flexibility, and I feel like coding had that. If you go on YouTube now, you are going to see a lot of YouTubers day in the life. A lot of them work from home, and I felt like that was something that I really, really wanted, and that is one of the reasons why I started learning how to code, because it's going to give me that flexibility. The second reason why I started learning how to code is because of the money. It's not like I don't like coding. I'm going to get into that very soon, but one of the reasons why I got into coding is because of the prospects of coding, at least at the time I got into coding. And I used to like, you know, seeing software developers day in the life. I just like how chill their life was. I also know a few people that are close to me that are software developers, and yes, I think I want that for myself as well. Before you come for me in the comments and say, oh my god, you're not supposed to do something because of money, you think I want to do anything? Same thing. What I want to do is just to wake up, live my big girl lifestyle, have my bath, you know, look good. But if I'm going to work, then I want it to be something worthwhile. Of course, I like to code. You know, I like challenges that come with coding. I'm like, God, what kind of challenge is this? And then when you solve it, you're so happy, like, oh my God, you're getting better. And I like to see coding and fashion in the same line, you know. Let's say in coding now, I'm trying to build a small website, blah, blah, blah. I'm trying to just build something. And also in fashion, I'm trying to create something for somebody to wear. In coding, I'm trying to, like, at least what I'm doing anyway, I'm trying to create a website for somebody to use. So it's all about creation, you know, it's all about creating something. And I feel like I love something creative, you know, whatever, I don't know. But yes, number two is because of the money, and also the fact that I get to create something. I think I like it. The third reason why I started learning how to code is because I always hear how people say, oh my god, coding is so hard, blah 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 blah. Well, other people are still going to be like, coding is hard, but they are doing it right. So I'm like, if other people can do it, then I can surely do it as well. So I'm like, you know what, let's give it a try. Like, I would like to really see what is hard in it and why people are really saying it is hard. Let me see if it is something I would like. So yes, that is one of the reasons I started learning how to code. Down the line, after a few months of me learning how to code, I've actually discovered that even if you don't necessarily do like front end or back end, there are still other places that, you know, coding will benefit you. For example, cloud engineering. So there's this guy that I follow on YouTube, Tech with Suleiman, and there was this video that I was watching. He was talking about transitioning to cloud engineering. Cloud engineering is one part of tech that is really, really catching my eyes. I don't want to be, you know, jumping from one place to another, but I feel like in the future I might consider going into cloud, because that guy has sold cloud engineering to me. Like, I watch a lot of his videos and I feel like cloud engineering is really cool. As I was saying, I watched one of his videos where he was talking about transitioning into cloud engineering, and he was like, it's actually a good practice that you know how to code like front end, back end, and then come into cloud, like you're going to be better, you know. And I also feel like it's not only in cloud that coding will be helpful. Coding can also be helpful in other parts of tech in case somebody is willing to dive in to tech like proper. I feel like coding will be very much beneficial. This is something that I've liked about coding after I started learning how to code. So moving on, we're going to talk about the challenges I've faced so far learning how to code. When I started learning how to code in 2023, one of the major challenges I faced is laptop. And I know that a lot of you will say that the reason why you cannot get into tech or the reason why you cannot do what you want to do is because you don't have a laptop. That is not an excuse. When I started learning how to code, you see the laptop that I had, it was better than not having a laptop at all, because that thing, what will I call this? Maybe I will call it palm top. I don't know what palm top looks like, but it's like just a little upgrade from phone, you know, just like a bigger screen. Maybe my phone even works better than the laptop I had so what I used to do when I started learning how to code was I used to borrow a laptop from my cousin. Then later on, I got my own laptop. So if you don't have a laptop now, guys, borrow and then save up to buy your own. Don't let laptop be a reason why you cannot code. Don't give me that excuse. Get on your Zoom, get up and start doing something. Especially those of you that are not doing anything with your life right now, get up and do something. Borrow if you have to borrow. My second major problem was getting the right tutor, and this one wasted my time. Oh my days. I feel like if I had like a specific roadmap on which tutor was best, or maybe if I checked YouTube and really searched for which tutor is good, which tutor is best for beginners, I would have gone faster. Before I got to the point where I got tutors that really resonated with me, it took a long time. I spent time and resources on courses that were not cutting it for me. When you're learning programming, sometimes it's like this person can know how to teach very well. Other people can say, oh my god, this person is good. But you can take the person's course and then you don't understand. And if you don't understand, you don't understand. There's nothing you can do about it. So you have to try the next person to see if their, you know, learning style suits you, their teaching style, to see if it suits you rather. That one took a long time for me. And if I had checked YouTube for the best courses, if I kept searching for like the best courses to learn how to code for beginners, then maybe my journey would have been faster. But I don't know, I was just trying a bunch of courses, and then that one wasted my time a lot. I'm not even going to lie, like a lot, slowed me down. And some courses were recommended by YouTube, but by the time you start taking them, they are too long. I don't feel like anybody should be taking extra long courses. I feel like short courses are better because they help you to get the basics, and then you can start taking projects, practicing projects, because project is the main work. It's not only to do tutorial. Project, actually building things I can see, is where the main work is. So I don't feel like anybody should be wasting time on taking tutorials. I feel like you should actually spend more time on practicing, because by the time you've finished taking all those tutorials, now it's time to build just a small website, a small landing page. It will be a problem. So guys, don't waste time on tutorials. It's not worth it. Do more of projects. That one will make your, you know, learning journey faster. My third challenge was getting stuck. Now if you have ever tried to learn how to code, you know that getting stuck is just a normal thing. You will get stuck. If you don't get stuck, what do you want to do? Like, it's just a normal thing. You will definitely get stuck. So then when I used to get stuck, what did I used to do? I was just like, the whole world was coming to an end. Sometimes I will ask, like I said, I have friends that are developers, but I didn't know how to really, I don't know. I used to ask them once in a while, but you know, sometimes some of us that don't like asking for help all the time, when it comes to the fact that, oh my god, you need to ask this person every time, just feeling like I'm disturbing this person and blah, blah, blah. So I don't know. So that one really slowed me down as well. But these days, guys, what I've discovered, it's ChatGPT. ChatGPT will solve all your problems. ChatGPT is just God sent. If you're learning how to code, ChatGPT is your best friend. Even if you have programmer friends, whatever, ChatGPT is a must have for everyone. How can you start learning coding by yourself? Learning coding by yourself is something that has to be self-determination. You can actually teach yourself anything. You can teach yourself how to code. I'm currently teaching myself how to code, but you need a lot of discipline, first of all. So that one you have to put down at the back of your mind, that you will need to be very, very disciplined. So the first thing you want to do is to choose a learning path. So if you are learning how to code, you want to build website, you first of all pick what part of coding you want to start with. From my research, I learned that it's good to start from being a front-end developer, and then when you get a job as a front-end developer, then you are going to start learning back-end. So the first thing you want to do is to choose a path. The path for front-end developer is to learn HTML, CSS, JavaScript. These are like the basics for learning how to code. You need to know these basics. So after that, you can now learn React. There's also TypeScript. So you just have to understand the path you are following and then follow it. HTML first, CSS second, learn those two, and then you go into JavaScript, learn it well, then you go into React. TypeScript is good too, so just know your basics and learn it. Number two is to find beginner friendly resources. Now if you go on YouTube, you are going to see a lot of people teaching how to do HTML, how to do JavaScript, blah blah blah, but it's not everything that is beginner friendly, so you need to look for beginner friendly courses. I would suggest, SheCodes. SheCodes is very 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 good for beginners, but it is only for women. So if you are a man, then I'm sorry, you are going to have to use something else, but for women, SheCodes got you. And also Angela Yu's course is good as well. Jonas Smetsman, or what's his name, yes, I feel like his course is good, but it's too long, very very time consuming. You don't remember maybe half of the things he's teaching later on, unless maybe you are really 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 really, you know, I don't know, but I just feel like his course is too long. He's front-end developer course, we're building, after he taught us the basics, then we're building this restaurant website. I feel like the website was too long, maybe it's me that was lazy at that time, but yes, Jonas Smetsman's course is also good as well. I'm going to leave links to all these courses in the description. So Angela Yu's course and Jonas Smetsman is on Udemy, and then SheCodes is on just the website, so make sure you check them out. Number three, guys, is to set small goals. Now if you just want to enter programming like that, you're going to get overwhelmed, you're going to get stuck, you will most likely want to run away, because let me not lie to you, coding is hard. I'm just going to give it to you like that. Coding is hard, but if you set small goals, like, okay, this is what I'm doing today. Today I'm going to build this small thing. Tomorrow I'm going to build something else. I'm going to learn HTML today. I'm going to learn how to put the heading tag, like, you know, just small things day by day, and then tomorrow you try to remember what you did yesterday. That's how to do small things at a time. Set small goals, crush your goals, do something else, try to remember what you did yesterday. That's the best way to learn coding, in my opinion. And the fourth thing is, don't be afraid to fail. See, if you are learning how to code, your code has a bug is a normal thing. As a beginner, if your code does not have a bug, that one calls for celebration, so just be thinking that, what's happening? But like, it's a normal thing for your code to fail. Don't be feeling like you're going backwards because your code failed, or your code has a bug, or it has an error. Just, you know, continue doing what you are doing. Just find a way to solve your error, and before you know what's happening, you will not make that mistake next time. For example, let's say you want to write math.round, and math is supposed to be in capital letter, and you put small letter, your code will not run. No, it will give you error. All those kind of things, it will make your code fail. So if you now say, okay, because my code failed, it didn't work, I'm going to give up. What are you doing? It's not me. You are doing yourself. So guys, it's just normal, okay? Don't be afraid to fail. If you fail today, you go again tomorrow. And also, if you are trying to like code and then you feel like today, oh my God, you're not productive, it's normal. I also feel like that sometimes. Even if maybe from morning till night, you were sitting on your laptop and then you were not productive throughout the day, it's nothing to be, you know, to feel bad about. Tomorrow you go again. Just put at the back of your mind that it is the end goal that matters, not just today, okay? Little efforts every day will add up to something. Even on days that you are not productive, it's still going to add up, I promise you. Number five is to post your progress. Now, a lot of times when you start learning how to code, you just feel like, oh my God, I'm learning how to code, blah blah blah, and then you tend to forget about it one way or the other. Maybe if you did it for like maybe 1 week, 2 weeks, you forget about it. If you're posting about it now, you know, some people will be commenting on your post, and then even you'll be like, ah, it's true, I've not yet added a post to do, I've not yet written one line of code to do, let me write it so I can post it to my followers. For example, on LinkedIn, you can post on LinkedIn, you can post on Twitter. And the good thing about posting your progress is that it helps recruiters to find you more. For example, there's time that I used to post about social media, blah blah blah, I was getting a lot of messages on people asking me to come and manage their social media then. But I don't know, I feel like I was not wise enough because I got one large gig and then I was saying that, oh, my year of experience was not enough. Like, I should have just gone ahead with the interview. All I'm saying, guys, is that post your progress. You never know who is watching, honestly. So, yes, that's my tip for you. Post your progress when you start learning how to code. Another benefit of posting your progress is that it keeps you accountable. You know, you're posting to people. People are watching your journey. So, you know, you just want to keep up with the momentum. I don't know if some of you are like that. Some of you will post today, you'll not post tomorrow. Anyway, I'm one of you anyway. But anyway, it's just good to post your progress, you know. Yes, thank you so much for watching this video. If this video was helpful in any way, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, guys, and let me know your thoughts in the comments. Do you think you'll be learning how to code? Have you tried learning how to code before? What challenges did you face? Did you face any of the challenges I've mentioned in the video? Let's have a chat below in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.